A tragic collision between a trailer and a fuel tanker, which subsequently caught fire at Butende village in Bugweri district on the Igangabujiri highway, claimed the life of an unidentified woman and left two others critically injured. The accident occurred at around 10 a.m. yesterday when a fuel tanker traveling from Iganga district, registration number ZG2941, collided head-on with a truck loaded with Simba cement from Toro district, registration number UBG347D. Busoga East Police spokesperson Diana Nandaula said investigations to determine the exact cause of the collision are ongoing.
Abadde yasiridde dda nga tasobola na kutegeerekeka omulambo we gutwaliddwa mu ggwanika ly'eddwaliro lya Iganga nga n'omusajja ateeberezebwa okubanga abadde mugoba ku mmotoka zino addusiddwa mu ddwaliro.
The police fire brigade arrived at the scene and extinguished the blaze before both vehicles were completely consumed by the fire. In Jinja, a taxi burst into flames yesterday evening, leaving two people dead and two others severely burnt. The 4:30 p.m. tragedy happened at Cleve Road East near the Iganga Road Junction when the Mbale-bound taxi suddenly went up in flames. This happened hardly 10 minutes after the vehicle left the Mbale stage in Jinja Taxi Park. Police in Boyogerere have arrested a man suspected of grabbing land and changing title details. He has been identified as Rasam Pija, aka Frederick Kavuma. Several victims of his scam were prompted to report to police. The police has been investigating the matter until they collected CCTV camera footage pinning his vehicle in a lodge. He was later trailed and arrested in Kasangati.
Biri kumineta no omame oyo eita Kavuma na alabi kako nga akaya nilitaka kutuli.
Mumanya gegabiramu nga gaita yeita Frederick Kavuma kizuuliddwa nti ye Rwasa Mpija Frederick
yatumbake ettaka lyaffe, yatwala ekibanja kyaffe ekiri ebweyogerere Kirinnya n'akibba nga yeerimbise nti mutabani wa William Rubowa Ntemboya.
Rasa has denied all the accusations, saying that the land is rightfully his. He added that every land case that has been taken to court has been able to win because he's the legitimate owner.
We mulaba bonna bonna banesibye ko kuba abampabira omusango mu court, High Court ya Land Division e Kampala. Nimpoza nabye myaka 10-12 nemba singa omusango.
Deputy Police Spokesperson for Kampala Metropolitan Local Studio confirmed the arrest and said investigations into the matter are underway. Polling stations across Rwanda opened for presidential and parliamentary elections, with the African nations leader Paul Kagame set to cruise to victory and extend his iron fist rule for another 5 years. The election pits Kagame against Frank Habineza of the opposition Democratic Green Party of Rwanda and Philippe Mpayimana, an independent. All three candidates ended their 3 weeks of campaigning in the capital Kigali on Saturday ahead of the polls. Rwandans are expected to cast their vote across 2,433 polling stations, which opened at around 7 a.m. and counting will begin as soon as they close at 3 p.m., with partial results expected to be released as tallying progresses, according to the National Electoral Commission. More than 500 candidates are vying for 80 seats in the Chamber of Deputies, the lower chamber of parliament. Here in Uganda, over 10,000 Rwandans cast their votes at the High Commission in Kampala yesterday.